Hello everyone, welcome back to another graphs video. Today we're going to talk about a highly requested feature for the graph system. Cutting, or mowing, or blowing it up, whatever means of removing you have in your game. If you haven't already, make sure you've read my main graph system article, or watched the previous graphs video, as this video builds upon the code and setup from there, and expects you to know how graphs is built up. I'll break down how the graph cutting works within the existing system and how to set it up. All the files you need are in the article linked in the description. Here's a quick rundown of how the cutting works. We will be adding a new buffer alongside the graph data buffer to store cutting information. We'll make a simple script to initiate cuts by sending the cutting position and a radius to the graph compute script. We'll use the culling tree to efficiently handle graph cutting. We'll be implementing alpha clipping in the shader to visualize the cut grass. And finally, we'll add some particles to make the effect look more convincing. So we're going to add another buffer to the grass system, but what does this actually mean? Right now we have a buffer with our base grass data. This contains the position, color, normal, and length and width of the grass. This new buffer will be the same size and will hold just one float, which will be the Y position of a cut. This way we can apply the cuts per graph data point. So in the graph compute script we make a new buffer of the same size as the graph data, and this will take a float. And the data we send to this buffer will be a float array. Again, the size will be the same as the graph data list. To start with, we initialize all numbers as -1, so we can check against it to confirm that a graph blade hasn't been cut yet. Now that we have a buffer to read and an array to send to it, we can try to test a cut. To cut the grass, we have a new simple script that will take the grass compute script and call a function in there that will send through the origin point of cutting and a radius of the cut. So let's try cutting with only a small amount of grass. In this case, we can just check the distance of all grass from the hit point, see if it's within our radius, and fill in the buffer value of that grass point with the Y value of the hit point. This is of course terribly slow if we had a ton of grass. We will fix that in a sec. As a quick test to see if we are sending the right data through, we can tell the grassblades.compute shader to skip rendering anything that isn't our default uncut value of -1. So now all the grass blades that have a value that isn't -1 are fully removed from rendering. Since we already have the grass divided into the cubes of our culling tree, we can use that to check a much smaller section of grass. Using bounds.contains, we can check if the cutting point is inside of the bounds of the node of the culling tree. And if it is, we grab all the grass IDs that are in that node and put them in a list. By increasing the size of the original bounds by the radius, we can also grab the IDs of the grass that is slightly out of the range, in the neighboring nodes. We do this to prevent literal edge cases like this, where the points in the next node over only get cut when the cutting object is inside of the bounds, even if the radius should be big enough to touch it. So from this function we get a much smaller amount of points to loop through. Now instead of skipping every cut grass point in the grass blade's compute shader, we can send through the cut buffer data so the final shader graph can read it. We do this by adding a new value in the struct for our final shader, reading the cut buffer, and sending it through in the grass triangle generation loop. Which brings us to the next part. The actual cutting effect is done by alpha clipping in the final shader. With the data from the cut buffer we stored in the vertex struct, we can now use it to perform alpha clipping to make it look like the grass is cut. The custom function here has gotten a new output value, which will store the cutting hitpoint.y. Using the point of cutting and the grass world position, we can create an accurate clipping point. With the step node, we can make sure that the values stay within the 0 to 1 range. Here's a visual representation of the step node, which we use to create a cutoff. We have a grass blade and a cut point. We check the grass world position of every pixel in the grass blade, and see if it's below the cut point. If it's not, we clip it. So now we are cutting the grass. One more thing to add is to spawn some particles while cutting, so we can have bits of grass flying around. I made a very simple effect here. Just used a mesh quad with two cuts and a slight twist, and set it to emit a few of these at the zero interval that shrink over time. You can pause the screen here if you want all of my settings. So I've implemented Unity's own object pool example for this, so the particle system gets a return to cut buffer script on it. Then the particles get spawned when a new cut is made or the current cut point is lower than the already existing cut point. Let's go over the setup. I'm starting here with the grass system from the last video slash article already in place. Again, this is all linked in the description and in the new post. And the first step is downloading all the files attached to the Patreon post. While bringing them in, some of them are new, you can just drop these into your project. And others will replace existing files. Easiest is to just open up both the original and the new one and pasting the code over, so you don't lose any references in the scene. The next step is to create a particle system. Make sure the looping bool is not checked. And here are again some of the settings I've used. And add the return to cut pool script to this. Turn this particle system into a prefab and add it to the grass settings object. Create an empty game object and attach the test cutting script to it. You will see a gizmo around it to indicate the radius of cuts. And during play mode, move the testing object around and you can see the grass being cut with particles flying around. So with all of the cutting done, how about adding a burnt effect? There's a quick way to do this by checking the value of the cut buffer, seeing if it's not a default value anymore, and then turning the main color to black. But you may have noticed that the extra buffer in the shaders is a float 4 and not a float. That's because I've left space there in case you want to add another buffer, for example to colorize the grass locally. You can then override the main color of the grass. Maybe you want to be able to freeze the grass or dry it out instead of just burning it. You can add an extra buffer of size 3 times float and do the same setup as the grass cutting, only with a vector 3 array instead of a float array, and then read the buffer in the compute shader. And with this you can change the color locally at runtime. And that's it. That was the breakdown of how the grass cutting feature works. Feel free to experiment with it. There are always more things you can add to this system, like using textures with quads instead of grass blades, or using the painting system with pre-made meshes. Have fun! For more resources, tips, tutorials on all sorts of topics, check out my GitHub site, and everything I do is supported by Patreon, so huge thanks to all my patrons. If you want to support me, go check it out. But that's it for today, see you in the next one.